So we have with us one of the biggest talents of Indian chess currently, Arjun Erigaisi. He's playing phenomenal chess in the last few months. Arjun, congratulations on your another wonderful performance at the Chennai Open.
Thank you.
So 8 out of 10.
Yeah.
And very nearly, I think you missed your IM norm again over here because of some technical difficulty. You didn't meet 5 title players.
Yeah.
But you already made an IM norm in Mumbai?
Yes.
So this would have been your second norm?
Yeah.
And what's your live rating?
It's 2458.
2458?
Yeah.
I think you will be like this Kramnik or these guys where they got their GM title before becoming an IM. So he's in great form and overall it seems from your games that you are much higher than the level of an IM.
Thank you.
So who are you learning chess from right now?
Viktor Mikhailovsky.
Viktor Mikhailovsky from
Israel.
Israel.
Yes.
He lives in US now, right? Or
in Israel only.
He lives in Israel.
Yeah.
How did you meet him and how did you start working with him?
Actually, my dad talked with him and said.
And it's where, like, how did it work out? You don't know.
In chess.com, he saw some his reviews and he said.
Okay, and you are enjoying working with him?
Yeah.
Okay, I have seen a few of his posts on Facebook. When you do well, he's a proud coach for your performance. So today, in the last round, you were facing a very strong player, Karthik Venkatraman. Have you played with him before?
Yeah, I played with him some 3 to 4 times and I lost every time.
Okay, so you must have been under some pressure.
Yeah.
Now, let's have a look at your game. You were playing with the black pieces and you played your favorite French.
Yes.
Knight c3. And this line,
I played knight f6.
Ah, first you played knight f6.
Actually, I was expecting e5 here. e5, nf, d7, f4, this tennis line.
Oops, sorry. Yeah, f4, c5.
Yeah, but he played bishop g5. This was unexpected for me. So I was feeling a draw is okay for me. It's all good. So I just wanted to take I just took d take c4 and played knight b d.
You played this line. It's a very solid line for black.
Yeah.
Didn't you play this also against Karthikeyan and Murli in Delhi?
Yeah, I did.
But that didn't go so well for you,
yes,
that game.
Yeah.
So you had your preparation, you had some improvement ready for?
Yes.
Okay. What happened?
He played knight f3. h6. Bishop takes f6.
Sorry. Okay, bishop f6.
Knight f6, knight f6, queen f6, bishop b5.
You think this move is...
Yeah, it's necessary.
It's necessary, why?
Yeah, because if direct bishop d3, then I can just play bishop d7.
Okay.
And if queen e2, then just long castling. And maybe if long castling, then bishop d6. And at some point, it will be useful for me to play bishop c6.
So, he forcing you to play c6 was important.
Yes.
So, bishop b5 check and you went c6. Now, your bishop will have less scope on c8. So, you went back and you played
bishop d7.
Bishop d7.
Queen e2. Bishop d6. I thought he would play knight e5 as Karthikeyan Murali played. But he just did long castling.
So what was the improvement you had over your game over Karthikeyan?
After knight e5, long castling, I should have played c5.
A short castle, yeah?
Yeah.
c5.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, this is the line, but I did not remember this.
So in the game against Karthikeyan, what did you play?
I played king b8.
Mm-hmm.
And he played b4 and I don't have a chance to play c5.
b4 and you couldn't take this pawn here in that game?
Maybe it's very risky. He can just play rook
b1. Bishop d6. And then he has compensation?
Yeah, I think so.
Perhaps bishop a6 is
possible.
And then if bishop c8, knight c6 is coming, then
maybe I should play b6, then a4, a5 or c4, c5.
Yeah, looks dangerous. So you had this improvement prepared for knight e5 in this position, but your opponent just long castled.
Yeah. Actually, I did not prepare improvement for this round. After finishing the game with Kartikeyan Murali, then only I prepared it. Because for this round, I did not expect the move bishop g5 from him.
Hmm. But it always pays to analyze your lost games.
Yeah.
And you always can learn a lot from that.
Yeah.
So that's advice from one of India's most talented players. Analyze your games. Arjun, how do you assess? You also long castle, right?
Yes.
How do you assess this position? You have the bishop pair, he has more space.
Yeah. Maybe slightly, white is slightly better or equality.
Okay.
Black should try for equality in this line.
And you have no problem, you know, even if the game was drawn, you are fine with that result. Okay.
Here he just played king b1. I wanted to play c5, but here king b8 is fine.
First you safeguarded your king.
Yeah. Next I can play c5 anyways. But here he played a4.
This somehow looks wrong, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you are going to play c5 and a4 would be attacked.
Yes, but I was a bit scared. But still I played c5. Here, actually I was thinking bishop e4.
Okay.
And I calculated c takes d4, knight takes d4, e5.
First of all, what is happening if I do take this guy here?
D takes c5.
D takes, bishop takes
queen c4.
Queen c4 and losing a piece.
Yeah.
Okay. So I cannot take on a4 and you are calculating cd.
Yes.
Knight d4.
e5.
e5.
Maybe knight b5.
Yeah.
Here I was thinking to play either bishop c5 or bishop takes b5.
Bishop takes b5. Maybe queen b5, no?
Queen e7.
In this opposite colored bishop position.
But maybe he is better.
He's slightly better because he has more active bishop.
Yes. He can play something like rook d3 and rook b3 also.
Yeah. So, this would have been, bishop e4 would have been the right move in this position.
I just thought.
Like it seems like a decent move. But he went for a5.
Yeah.
I think he wanted to mate you.
Yes.
So, you took on d4.
Yeah.
Now, you had no choice but to be brave.
Yes.
And he went a6.
I played e5.
e5.
Yeah. I was actually calculating a takes b7 here.
Right. I don't think you want to take that pawn.
No, I just wanted to play bishop c7 here.
And why bishop c7? Because more natural may look bishop c6, right?
But I did not want to take his b7 pawn even with the bishop. And he can trade the bishops with the
bishop. He can trade the bishops here. So, you would have played bishop c7?
Yeah.
With the idea of?
Rook h8 and removing the queen to, coming the queen to b6 and at some point f5.
Ah, okay. Nice. So, bishop e4, a5, cd4, a6, e5. And instead of ab7?
He played bishop b5.
When did you start feeling confident about your chances?
Actually, after bishop b5, I played bishop c7. I think it's better to take on b7.
Okay.
I was thinking bishop c6. Bishop takes, queen takes, knight e5, queen e6, f4, f6, queen c4.
And he saved his bishop.
Yeah.
Saved his piece, knight.
Yeah. But the mate, I can win the b7 pawn back.
You
and
can
the
take and also f4 is hanging.
Then maybe knight a5. okay, maybe I will get the b7 pawn and lose the d4 pawn.
Mm-hmm. And if you take king b7, in general this should not be bad for you.
Yeah.
I was under the impression that you wanted to keep the e5 pawn, so perhaps playing rook h8 could also be a... Okay, then there is bishop d7, yeah?
Yeah, bishop d7, rook d7, queen b5.
And also knight d4?
Yeah, both.
Knight d4 is strong. So, that's why this is not working. Anyway, he didn't play over here AB7, he went for...
Bishop takes d7.
Okay.
Rook takes d7. A takes d7. And here after rook d5, I felt confidently.
Yeah, this is a nice move, defending e5 and now queen b6.
And at some point, rook a5 and queen c6, queen a4, something like that.
And you will mate him.
Yeah.
Okay. Then how did it go?
He played c3. I think it's not a good move. I just played queen g6, queen c2. d3.
Ah, you got a passer, yeah?
Yeah. Queen b3. Rook a5. Threatening d2. And also queen a6.
Mm-hmm.
His only move is to play knight d2.
So d2 and queen a6 both are big threats.
Yeah.
Play knight d2.
Queen a6. King c1.
Ah, he's now in trouble there.
Yeah. I can play rook a1, but I did not find much after that. Rook a1, knight b1, queen g6, rook d2, queen takes g2, rook hd1, e4, queen takes f7, queen g5, but he can play b4 here. Okay, still it's better for me only, but still it...
Because if you go bishop f4, he wants
king
to go king b2.
Yeah.
Isn't this working here, rook b1?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Perhaps you will win a rook, yeah? I mean a piece.
A piece, yeah.
Yeah, I think this should be better for you now with bishop f4 coming.
Yeah, maybe.
But you calculated this long line and you wanted to keep control, so you didn't give a check.
Yeah.
And what did you play?
I just played rook b5.
Okay.
Queen a3. Queen takes, pawn takes, rook d8.
Rook d8, okay.
And now it's maybe winning for me. Because my d3 pawn is very strong and his b7 pawn is falling.
Okay.
He played c4 here. I took rook b7. He played rook h1. If instead of that, if knight e4, then I can just play bishop b6. If c5, then rook c7. And I can win another pawn and win the game. So he played rook h1 after rook b7. I played f5.
Now you're getting e4 and
he
had to play f3 maybe?
Yes, he played. I played bishop d6. Knight
b1.
E4.
E4.
Yeah. If pawn takes, then bishop f4, knight d2, rook c8.
Yeah, this is a beautiful mate actually. Yeah? I mean, he's no way to get out of this mate, rook into c4.
Yeah.
Very nice. You're tactically very alert. Fe, so he didn't take Fe, right?
He played g3.
G3.
I played rook c8. And he gave resign.
He resigned the game.
Yeah.
Already. Yeah, this looks horrible. If he moves out to d2, I think you will just pick up the pawn and then he can't even win the e4 pawn.
Yes.
So, beautiful game, Arjun. As I saw in the game that tactically you're very sharp. Do you also think that is your biggest strength as a player?
Maybe.
You're not sure what you're good at, or you're good at everything, huh?
Not like that.
And what do you do apart from chess in academics? Which grade are you in?
Ninth class.
ninth class, and you are trying to maintain both your chess and education, or you want to just focus on chess?
Now I am just focusing on chess, but from 10th class I will focus on it.
But what if you become a GM within 6 months?
Then I should see.
So if he becomes a GM, then he will focus more on chess than education, yeah?
Yeah, I will think.
Okay, you will think about it. And what is the way in which you work on chess? Is there a specific way? You work with your coach, Mikhailovsky, but apart from that, what do you do?
He will send me some homework like studies, middle game positions, and I will just solve it.
Okay. So, do you work on chess on your own with some of your own material, or it's always with the coach?
Yes,
and
sometimes on my own, but most probably my coach helps.
Okay, okay. So, Arjun, we congratulate for you for this very nice game. Also, I think you will finish in top 3 in this tournament. So, congratulations, and which tournament is next for you?
Aeroflot
Open. Within a few days, it will begin, like around 10 days or 15 days?
20 days.
20 days, so you have time to recover.
Yeah.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.